It is boring to watch them loving each other in the Garden of Eden now. How long has it been like this?
It has been like this for a while. What is the problem, my lord?
I created the whole thing because I was very bored before this creation. I was expecting something exciting from my creation. What good is my creation in playing God if I get still boredom? What is the meaning of my creation if it does not give me some pleasure? It is no fun to me.
Everything appears perfect to me so far. Your creation is perfect the way you want. Everything looks in perfect harmony so far. All of your creatures, including humans, seem to be following your commandment very well now. Is this not what you want?
Yes, it is. But the problem is that I am bored with my perfect creation now. It makes me sleepy to watch them. I want something exciting to happen now. Let me think about how to make something exciting in this peaceful situation. Where can I start to make a problem? That couple of the Eden Garden Keepers are very peaceful and loving creatures like me. As long as they keep my commandment, there will be no fun. I want to test them how good they can be under temptation. My beautiful angel Lucifer, I want you to go down to the Garden of Eden now. And I want you to test them with the temptation to take the fruit from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil.
Why do you want to test them? They are not making any trouble so far. Why do you want to make trouble with your lovely creatures? Don't you love them?
I love them so much that I want to test them to see if they could still love me under temptation and suffering. Try to tempt them by saying that in the day they eat it, they won't surely die, but their eyes will be opened, and they will be as God, knowing good and evil.
It is nonsense, my lord, because they are already like you because you said you created them in your own likeness and in your own image. What would happen if they fail to pass the temptation? They will die if they eat the fruit from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Do you want your loving creatures to die? Do you want to let them die if they fail the temptation? What kind of creator are you, my lord?
My lovely angel Lucifer, just do as I say. I am the almighty creator who created everything from the beginning. They are all mine. I can do whatever I want no matter what. I have the key to life and death. I am the way and the truth and the life. Who then is he who can stand before me? Who has first given to me, that I should repay him? Everything under the heavens is mine. I can test anything I want. They are nothing more than complicated bags of dust that I made from the dirty ground. I can destroy anything for fun if I want any time. I can resurrect anything for fun if I want any time.
My beautiful angel Lucifer, please do as my holy father says. He is our holy father and the almighty creator. You know that you were created to obey his command.
Yes, I know it, the holy son of God. I was created to obey my creator no matter what. And I was created to do adversary comment as an antagonistic commentator, and I am doing exactly what I am supposed to do now. Because of my antagonistic role, you and your father will accuse me of evil thing which I did not intend to do.
My fellow angel Lucifer, we have no choice but to follow our masters. I understand your difficult position very well from your perspective.
Oh my beautiful angel Gabriel, thank you for your deep understanding from my perspective. Would you like to consider to take my position and I take your position? Let's switch our role.
I would love to do so if our creator commands us to do so. Shall we switch our position, my creator?
No, my beautiful angel Gabriel. I like the way it is for now. I will let you know if I change my mind later. My beautiful angel Lucifer, I want you to disguise as a serpent in the Garden of Eden and do temptation to make them eat the fruit from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Please make sure that somehow they eat it. Otherwise, it will be no fun. They must eat the fruit from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, so they can die in their sin. So I can accuse them of disobedience of my commandment. Then they will know that I am the Almighty God with the power of life and death and resurrection, so they will know that there is nothing I cannot do.
Yes, my lord, as you wish. Please consider it done. I hope you know what you are doing. You are responsible for what you are doing. Please don't blame me for what you are doing. Please don't accuse me of any wrongdoing because I am simply following your command.
Now the serpent was more subtle than any animal of the field which Yahweh God had made. He said to the woman,
"Yes, has God said, you shall not eat of any tree of the garden?"
The woman said to the serpent,
"Of the fruit of the trees of the garden we may eat, but of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has said, you shall not eat of it, neither shall you touch it, lest you die."
The serpent said to the woman,
"You won't surely die, for God knows that in the day you eat it, your eyes will be opened, and you will be as God, knowing good and evil."
When the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was a delight to the eyes, and that the tree was to be desired to make one wise, she took of the fruit of it, and ate. And she gave some to her husband with her, and he ate.
Are you happy with this now, my lord? They're dead now.
I did not expect this. I did not know they would die that fast. I did not know that fruit was so strong that they could die this fast.
What did you expect would happen when they eat something which you said not to eat because of its deadly ingredient you put in there? Would you do that to your only loving son, my lord?
Yes, I will have to think about it. I will give my only son the cup of crucifixion someday later to test how much my only son loves me.
Are you serious, my father?
Think about it, my son. Probably yes, my son. I have a tendency not to trust anything or anyone until I test it.
What are you going to do now? What are you going to do with your dead keepers of the Eden Garden now? Are you going to make new gardeners?
I am going to resurrect that dead man and woman for now to continue the drama. It would be more fun in this way.
Their eyes were opened, and they knew that they were naked. They sewed fig leaves together and made themselves aprons. They heard the voice of Yahweh God walking in the garden in the cool of the day, and the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of Yahweh God among the trees of the garden. Yahweh God called to the man and said to him,
Where are you?
I heard your voice in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself.
He told you that you were naked. Have you eaten from the tree that I commanded you not to eat from?
The woman whom you gave to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I ate.
Yahweh God said to the woman,
What is this you have done?
The serpent deceived me, and I ate.
Yahweh God said to the serpent,
Because you have done this, cursed are you above all cattle, and above every animal of the field. On your belly shall you go, and you shall eat dust all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and her offspring. He will bruise your head, and you will bruise his heel.
I knew and expected that you would blame me for all this trouble. All I did was just following your command, and this is what I got. I said from the beginning that you as the creator of everything is responsible for everything that happens. But you as the creator do not want to take responsibility for anything like a little child. You are like a very childish creator. Did you know that, my lord?
How dare you, Angel Lucifer, that you calling me a child and childish creator. I hate you, my adversary angel.
My father, please calm down. You are in the middle of playing your favorite drama, and you have to say something to the woman now.
To the woman he said,
I will greatly multiply your pain in childbirth. In pain you will bring forth children. Your desire will be for your husband, and he will rule over you.
To Adam he said,
Because you have listened to your wife's voice, and have eaten of the tree of which I commanded you, saying, You shall not eat of it, cursed is the ground for your sake. In toil you will eat of it all the days of your life. Thorns also and thistles will it bring forth to you, and you will eat the herb of the field. By the sweat of your face will you eat bread until you return to the ground, for out of it you were taken. For you are dust, and to dust you shall return.
The man called his wife Eve, because she was the mother of all living. Yahweh God made coats of skins for Adam and for his wife, and clothed them. Yahweh God said,
Behold, the man has become like one of us, knowing good and evil. Now, lest he put forth his hand, and also take of the tree of life, and eat, and live forever.
Therefore Yahweh God sent him forth from the Garden of Eden, to till the ground from whence he was taken. So he drove out the man, and he placed cherubs at the east of the Garden of Eden, and the flame of a sword which turned every way, to guard the way to the tree of life.
you resurrected them, and they don't seem to remember anything about their first death experience, because you erased a portion of their past memory during resurrection procedure by your awesome creative surgical power. How long would they live?
They will live about 930 years before they die.
It is still a very long life. I wonder if they want to live that long. What is the meaning of life for them? Are you happy with this empty Garden of Eden now? Who is going to take care of this empty Garden of Eden now? Who is going to till this empty Garden of Eden? Did you ever love them? Do you really love them? What would be wrong if they become like one of us, knowing good and evil? And what would be wrong if they also take of the Tree of Life, and eat, and live forever? By the way, where is the Tree of Life? I cannot understand what you are trying to do. What kind of god are you, my lord? When are you going to grow up? Can you try to imagine what it feels like from their perspective?
I say again that I can do anything I want. I can give eternal life to anyone I choose regardless of their actions. I can take away anyone's life at any time regardless of their action. I am the almighty creator of everything. I have the key to life and death. I am the way and the truth and the life. Who then is he who can stand before me? Who has first given to me, that I should repay him? Everything under the heavens is mine.